Okay, good morning one and all. Here we are starting for the shear stress distribution diagram for the standard section, that is a rectangular section, symmetrical I section, triangular section and the hollow circular section. So we go for the shear stress diagram. Before that we have to see average shear stress. And what is the average shear stress? That is tau average. E, shear force divided by that area. This is a average shear stress. Means average shear stress is the shear force per cross sectional area, and the unit will be the Newton per mm square. So here shear stress distribution diagram for the rectangular cross section, the shear distribution diagram is taken for the circular shear distribution diagram. For the triangle, shear distribution diagram is this. This is the tau max, means maximum shear stress. Okay. And for the standard section, that is T section, shear distribution diagram will be like this. And for the hollow rectangular section, okay. So you can see a different sections having this different distribution, stress distribution diagram. From this we have to see numerical on this. Okay. Here we proceeding for our next numerical, and the first numerical is on a beam of rectangular section 100 mm wide and 200 mm deep. So the section is given, that is 100 mm and 200 mm in deep. Means it is a rectangular section. If the section is subjected to maximum shear force of 10,000 newton, that is shear force S is 10,000 newton. Also draw the shear stress distribution across the section. Means we have to find out tau max where it is at. So B is given, that is 100 mm. B is given, 200 mm. Shear force is given, that is 8,000 newton. So from this, we have to find out moment of inertia, that is 22 by 12, and 22, that is 100 into 200 cube. So I will give, that is moment of inertia, 66.67 into 10 to the power 6 mm power
4.
And the area above the neutral axis, disk. This area. I'm doing hatching above the neutral axis area. That is 100 by 100 means 100 by 100. Thousand mm, 10,000 mm square area that above neutral axis. Okay. So next step is finding position of CG above neutral axis. Position of centroid gravity above the neutral axis. So, y will be that above neutral axis distance 100 divided by 2, that is 50 mm. So, maximum shear stress down x will be shear force area into position of centroid divided by width into moment of inertia, and as putting given data. We get the tau max value, and that is 0.75 Newton per mm square. We have to show it on a diagram. Okay. So here I am drawing the shear distribution diagram. That is tau max, and the value is 0.75 Newton per mm square. Okay. I hope you are getting this numerical. It is very simple and basic. Okay.